Welcome to the clinic. Today we are updating your medical history within this book, and we are doing a section on the cranial nerve exam. Okay, so to begin, we have a skin inspection. See the small hair, bend over, scan area of the skin, start at the forehead, work down to the left and right, recording anomalies, scars, acne, bruises, cuts. Okay. So, to begin with, I will pull out a pen light, and if you don't mind just looking straight ahead, I will be starting analyzing your skin with your forehead. So I'm just going to brush your brains aside. Looking at your skin. Looking for any abnormalities. Forehead looks good. Little bit of acne at the start of the forehead, but that's to be expected. Okay. I'm just going to part your hair out of the way a little bit. Okay. And for this side. Looking good. Brings up, just looking at your eyebrows. Just looking for anything, okay. Looking at the bridge of your nose. Apologies, this is bright. Okay. Cheeks. Okay. Working at your upper lip and your gums. Okay, and your mouth and lips. Okay, looking good. Pencil, go through their hair, normal analysis. Okay. So now I will be going through your hair. It says use a pen or a pencil, but I don't have a mechanical pen. I only have an ink pen. So I'll just be using my finger, if you don't mind. To sift through your hair and look for any abnormalities. I will have to get a bit closer, so I hope you don't mind. Just look down for me. Looking at the scalp. Looking for any abnormalities, any bumps, dry or dead skin, dandruff, any scars. Any acne, bruises, okay, alrighty, looking good. I will take note of that. Okay. Okay. Alrighty, up next is facial motor movements. So, let's see here. So, for this first examination, it's going to be pretty simple. I'm going to be putting my hands on your lower jaw. And if you would please, just keep your jaw shut. And now try your best to open your jaw. Okay. Try to open it. Good. All right. And now I'm going to try and push your jaw open. I want you to try and keep it shut, okay? So, don't let me open it. Alrighty. Looking good. And back to where we were. Okay, good. Okay. And the patient focus on either your fingertip or pen tip. So left, up, down. Okay, good. Alrighty. This one should be easy. So I would ask you to just focus on the tip of the pen, if you can. And I want you to keep your head straight and just follow the movements. Let me know if there's any discomfort, any dull vision. So I want you to focus right on the tip of the pen. And okay, good. Was there any discomfort in that? Alrighty. Moving on to facial sensations. Tell the patient to close their eyes and feel a soft sensation or sharp pain. Alright, so it calls for either a pen and a finger, but again, it's an ink pen, not a mechanical pen. So I will be using my pen light instead. So, this is the pen light. You'll touch your cheek with it to let you get familiar with how it feels. And this is going to be the hard sensation. And this is my fingertip. This is going to be your soft sensation. So get familiar with how that feels. Okay. And now I want you to close your eyes and let me know which one you feel. Okay. Let's begin. Hard, good. Soft, good. Soft, good. Hard, good. Soft, very good. Hard, good. Hard, very good. Hard again, very good. Soft, good. Soft, very good. Hard, good. Soft, good. Hard, good. Soft, good. Soft again, good. And soft again. Very good. Very good. Hard. Good. And hard. Good. Alright, I believe that you did perfect. So, I'm going to go back where we were. One second. Alrighty. And I'll record. You did excellent. So for this next part, I am going to be simply dragging my finger across your face. Might feel a bit weird, but the purpose of this is to see if there's any place where you might lack sensation. So just let me know. I will go over the areas. You can open your eyes for this, and let me know if you stop feeling it at all. So I'll start with the forehead. Eyebrow. The right eyebrow. Okay. The bridge of your nose. Your temples. Okay, I'll be doing your cheeks too. And if you could close your eyes real quick, I'll be gently rubbing over your left eye. Okay, and now for your right eye. You may open your eyes now. If you wish. Okay, now your left gum. And your right gum. And I'm going to trace your mouth. And your lips, if you don't mind. Okay, still feeling everything. That's good. And finally, your jawline. Very good. Alrighty. Okay. Alright. Examination. Utilizing an ophthalmoscope, view the area around the patient's eye. Recording observations, next eye, surface of the eye, and have the patient look right, then left, then up and down. Okay. So, for the cranial nerve exam, let me pull my thumbs out. There we go. Okay, I will be asking you, oh, first of all, I do need to scoot up a little bit. Okay, I'll be looking to try the thumbs out. Please just look straight ahead. Alright, but actually for this part, I would like you to close your eyes while I just look over the outside of your eye for any condition of your skin, anything around your eye, your eyelashes, okay, looking good, and now for the other eye. Is looking good. Okay. And now could you open your eyes? Okay, and look straight ahead. I'll just be looking at the surface of your eye. Okay, look to your left. Now look to your right. I'll gently pull your eyelid down as you look up, please. Blood vessels are all looking healthy. And now look down while I gently pull your eyelid up. Good. Alright, now for this right eye. Okay, just gonna scan the surface. Actually, there we go. Okay, I'm using a green light. Get a better view. Start by looking down, please. And now look up. And now look to your left. To your right. Okay, good. Now just look straight ahead. You can open both eyes. Need to look inside your eye. You're looking for your veins, optic nerve, artery, macula, and your fovea. Okay. Okay, so I will pull my ophthalmoscope back out. Okay. So just hold steady. Look straight into the light for me. Okay. Veins look healthy. A nice pink optic nerve. Fovea and macula are well defined. Looking healthy. Okay. looking good. I was reanalyzing the outside of your eye a little bit there too. Always safe to double check. And now for your right eye. So hold steady again, look into the light. You've been doing it very well. Healthy looking veins, healthy looking optic nerve. No thing is out of the ordinary. Again, your is looking good. Alrighty, and now to review the surface of your eye. Okay, good. Alrighty. Paper for that one. Light responses. Okay. Tell a patient looks your head and you put your nose all behind you. You don't need a small eye, but don't you turn this stuff. Okay. So, for this one, I'm going to have you look straight ahead, right at my nose. Okay. And I'll be shining a bright light in your eye. So, if you could just look straight ahead, I'll be testing your consensual response. Okay, and your direct response for the right eye, sorry. Your direct left eye response. And the consensual. Lastly, I'll be placing my hand right here on your bridge of your nose, and I'll just do the swinging light test. Down. Okay. 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 So, next is just a recovery test of sorts. So, I'm going to gently place the palm of my hand over your right eye. And I'm going to have you just, again, look right at my nose. For the recovery. Good. Alrighty, good. Both eyes seem perfectly in sync there, despite the difference in height, which is very good. Okay. Okay, let's use the whole page again. Olfactory nerve tests. So, for this one, I'm going to have to get a bit closer again. I'm going to be, if you could look for me, I'll be looking up your nose, looking at your nostrils and seeing if they're healthy. Gray blockages in the left nostril. Looking good. And for the right nostril. Okay, good. Alrighty. Now, I'm gonna ask you to close your mouth and take a deep breath. Deep breath in. And out. And now I'm going to plug up your left nostril. And now again, breathe in. And out. And now again, but opposite. So breathe in. And breathe out. Good. All right. Okay. To the oral examination. Okay. Gently go through the side. Alright. So, I'm gonna put my hands on your throat, and I would like you to just swallow repeatedly. Okay. Good. Alright, and it says record alterations this part. So things go normal. Just making sure everything is in place. Alright. And okay. Exhalation, open the mouth. Alrighty, so if you could just open your mouth and say ah. Okay, and so we're looking at the lips, gums. Okay, uvula looks good. Hard and soft palate look good. Your tonsils look healthy. Okay. Alright. Sorry, I'm looking at the book. It's got a useful little chart for everything. Okay. So just looking through your teeth. Everything looks healthy and good. Everything is within reason. Nothing seems out of the ordinary or of alert. So, I'll just write down that everything looks good. I wrote it in much more scientific terms than that, but on to our last test. It is an ear examination. So, you know, either a small eye or a bent or outer ear. Okay, so just an outer ear examination. And, okay, so we're looking at your helix, anti-helix, tragus, antragus, lobule. Okay. So, I will get out my light. And if I could have you look in that direction, please, that would be much appreciated. And I'm just going to take a look inside your ear. Bit of earwax. Nothing is red. No issues I don't see. Okay. And now for your other ear. You can look in the opposite direction for me, please. Good. Again, lots of earwax. Good. So, I will write this down. Only thing I noticed is that there is quite a lot of earwax, so you should get that cleaned sometime soon. But other than that, your health seems to be perfect. Okay, I'm gonna just write this down. That'll be all for today. We have everything we need in this book. Let's go back. Right. We went over the skin inspection, facial motor movements, facial sensations, ocular examination, ocular responses, olfactory nerve tests, oral examination, and the ear examination. All laid out in this book. So, all that data will be uploaded online and sent to your other doctors. And thank you for coming in. Have a good one. Goodbye.